Hi, and thanks for joining me. In this video, we're going to talk about how you can add script to a Google Sheet so that you can use it to send emails regarding the sheet that you're editing. Now, in this situation, I have a student progress report that I fill out on a weekly basis. And I have one of these student progress reports for each student in my program. And where I could normally use a Google form to fill out just a John Smith week of October 31st and just a comment about their progress and then submit that and have it automatically emailed out to the parent, that would mean that every time I fill it out, that all of that information for multiple students would be collected in one sheet. And I'd rather not have that because I'd like to keep each student's progress in a running sheet or timeline like I have here, and then share that with the parents. So sometimes you really just need a Google Sheet to do the job that you have. But the dilemma that I ran into is, how do I edit this document each week with a comment such as keeping up good work and send it out to the parent without having to, one, you know, share that with the parent, and then two, copy the link and then go into my email, type up a message, insert the link, and send it out to the parent. Well, there actually is a way to avoid all that by running a script. So if you're not familiar with this, go up to the Tools menu on your Google Sheet and click on the Script Editor. Now, the Script Editor is quite a cool thing because you can add all sorts of functions to your sheets so that your sheets can do different jobs, perform different tasks. And in this case, I want to write a function so that it sends an email. And it just so happens I keep some of the scripts that I'm using in Google Keep so that I can get to them quite frequently. That way I don't have to memorize them necessarily. But the basis of the script that I'm using looks like this. So the function that we're going to use is basically a send email function, and I just called it send email. In this section right here, you can type anything that you want. If you go back to the script here, it says my function. You can rename that anything you want. And in my case, I named it send email. And then you've got your brackets, open and closed parentheses, and then open bracket. And the function that we're going to use, this one's important because you don't want to edit this one. The function we're going to use is mailapp.sendEmail. And then from there we have open parentheses and in quotation marks, I can list the email address of whoever I want to receive the notification that I filled out this progress report. Close the quotation marks, comma, open quotation marks, and then subject. And it will enter whatever I type here in the subject line of the email. And of course you close that off, comma, quotation marks, body. Whatever is typed here can be the body of the message that I'm sending by email. And then of course you close your quotation marks, parentheses, semicolon, and then close bracket. So I'm going to post this code on my blog along with this video that you're watching so that you can kind of see the basis for what I did. But I took this script and I turned it into this one. And in this case, you know, I left email address as it is so that I could change it depending on the student and the parent. And then for the subject line, it's weekly progress update. And then of course I have a message here in the body. And it says this email is a weekly update of your student's progress. Please review this week's progress report here. And then I left a spot where I can put the URL of the sheet associated with that student. So the reason I put this in Google Keep this way is that every time I create a progress report sheet that I'm going to use throughout the year, like this one, okay, this is going to be used all year long, I can send out a notification of whatever I've added here just by clicking a button. I'm going to show you how to do that. So first thing we need to do is copy this script. And I'm going to go back to my script editor and I'll highlight all this and paste over it. And in this case, I'm going to highlight the email address. And let's say the email address of the parent, we type it right here. But if you put a comma, you can enter as many email addresses as you want as long as you stay inside these quotation marks for the email address. So I could send it to two or three or four email addresses. In the case that I'm using it, I send it to the student, the parent, and the counselor, so that the counselor has an updated weekly message that tells how the student is doing in our online program. But for right now, I'm just going to run a test on this, so I'm going to send it to my my email address only. Then on weekly progress update, that again is your subject line. I could just put dash J Smith for John, little Johnny Smith. And then I'm going to leave the message as is, but so that the parent will be able to reference the Google Sheet that I've typed all these messages in, and they can also look back and see every other comment from every other week, I'm going to make sure that this sheet is first of all shared so that anyone with the link can view, and in this case it is. And then I'm going to go up and copy the URL for this Google Sheet, and down here at the end of the message, I'm going to highlight over URL and paste that address for that sheet. And then that's it, I'm done. So I do need to title this script. I'm going to click up here and I'm going to say J. Smith script. That way I can know that that's the script associated with this student's progress report. And then of course right here you see this red asterisk next to the code for this tab. You need to make sure that you save. If you see that red star, that red asterisk, that means that you have unsaved changes. And so click the save button and we're ready to go. Now the key thing to remember here is that the function for this script is called send email. So I'll need to remember that. So when I go back over here, now what I need to be able to do is I need to have something that I can click on so that it automatically runs that script and sends an email to whoever I've included in this function. So to do that, I'm going to go to Insert, Drawing, okay, and we're going to use Google Drawings and we're just going to make a button. So we'll go to Shapes, I'll just grab a button here and double click in there and I'm going to say Send Email, and that's the text on my button. We'll kind of make this look a little bit nicer. We'll even add a little drop shadow to it. Just copying that shape. I'm going to fill it in black with a black border. Send it to the back. Looks like it's got a little drop shadow now. Of course, you don't really have to do all this. This is just me playing around. I'm going to group all that together. There's my button, and I hit save and close. So now I have this button on my sheet that I can click anytime to run that script, but right now it won't do anything, it's just an image. So I have to select it as I have here, and I'm gonna click this drop down menu and hit assign script, and the script I wanna run, remember, is send email, all one word with no spaces, because that is what I called that function back here. So I've put in the script send email, I'll click OK. And so now I'm ready to go. And so if I type in a message such as good job, and I'm done leaving comments for that progress report this week, then I can click send email and it says finished script. So now if I go back and look in my email, I can see if that email was sent to me. Because if you remember, I was the email address that I listed as the parent in the script here. So if I go to my email, let's check and see if it was received. If I go here, here it is, weekly progress update. And it says this email is a weekly update of your student's progress. It came. The subject line is just as we showed it would be in the script. And of course, here's the link to that Google Sheet so I can click on it, or we have a thumbnail that I could click on here. And if I click, I can see the messages that the instructor has left for the student that week. And of course, I have access to it anytime I want. But as the teacher, anytime that I want to go back and leave messages for that student and ensure that the parent has it, I can just type and then click send email and I'm done. I don't have any extra steps. I don't have to create an email inside my Gmail account and paste the link to this sheet. It's a quick, easy little script to run, and it creates a workflow that will save you tons of time. So hopefully this has been a help to you. If you have questions, Just visit techiecoach.com and leave me a message. And thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.